Hello and welcome back to the Movies Archives. This is your host, Movies Rex, and we are playing Fallout 3. Last time we reached Vault 112, and these robots are trying to get me into the Tranquility Lounger. We just need to check around. Rogue Rain won't talk to me. Check around, see what's here. There might actually be nothing in this vault other than the Tranquility Loungers. But we will check anyway. And hack our way through. Oh, we can't get through there. So we're down here on the Tranquility Lounger floor. There's a couple broken ones. With what looks like zombified humans in them. Look, it's poking into their brains. Hey, look, it's my dad. All right, can't open the broken Tranquility Lounger. So I just have to hop in an empty one. Simpson, unoccupied, so that's a broken one. Couple of Nesbombs, Rockwells. Subject unknown, that would be my father. Henderson. I don't see Braun. So Rockwell's stress level is elevated. One of the Rockwells, at least. Both Rockwells. And Dithers is extreme, requires imminent medical... Oh, never mind. Dead. Dithers is... dead. My father... possible program corruption... unable to verify resident ID. Henderson, I think, is also high stress level. No, not Henderson. Simpson. Elevated. So Simpson and Dither. Well, Dither's dead. Alright, I'm just gonna poke around back here just to make sure I've covered all the bases, seen what's in this vault before hopping into the loungers. There is a med bay that has nothing. Pack of cigarettes and a couple scalpels. Some medics and some stuff in first aid. Huh. Wonder if I'm missing anything here. So Dr. Brom, who my father came to see, who, what was it? Pinkerton was talking about, doesn't appear to actually be in here. So, I guess we'll just put that as a suspicious event and sit in the lounger. Please stand by. I guess I'm just some boy.
Hey there, sport. Beautiful day, isn't it?
Hi, say, George Nesbaum. You should go talk to Betty. Mr. Nesbaum.
She's waiting for you over on the playground. Have fun, sport.
Hiya, kiddo. What's the good word?
Nice day, yeah, isn't it?
You've got that right. Heck of a day to get some work done outdoors.
What can you tell me about the neighborhood?
Nice place. Real nice. Everyone's friendly and always happy to lend a hand.
Have you seen my dad?
Can't say that I have, kiddo. Don't worry. I'm sure he'll turn up.
I have to go now.
Have a great day.
Hiya.
So this is T. Nesbaum.
Hi there. I'm Timmy. Wanna play?
Have you seen my dad?
Your dad? Nope, I haven't. Did he get lost?
Sure did. What can you tell me about the neighborhood?
It's okay, I guess. I don't really have nobody to play with, except for Betty. And she's kind of, well, she's mean.
I can believe that. Bye, Timmy.
See you later.
La 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 la. Happy fun time music. So I'm looking for something here that's kind of cracks in the facade. Cracks in the veneer. Dark basements. I just wanted to check my Pip-Boy, and I guess that doesn't exist here.
Roger suggested we move here. I don't quite remember when that was.
Hmm.
It's very nice. We're doing quite well.
So she doesn't remember when they moved here. I haven't talked to anybody about the crazy experiment
yet. Good day. Well, George and I have been here.
As long as you can remember.
As I can remember.
Like 200 years? Yeah.
Have a great day.
Hey, look, there's a dog. Hi, boy. Doc. Good doggy. Nothing too suspicious here. And we have a computer terminal. Huh. So Dithers is dead, if you don't remember. We're gonna check this place out.
Not real. Not real.
No, Dithers, it's not.
You don't belong here. You're not supposed to be here.
Indeed.
It's not real. None of it. It needs to end. The suffering must end.
Finally, someone who knows what's going on. How do I get out of here?
We're not really here. We're not really talking. It's all made up. Make believe. We're sleeping, dreaming.
Indeed we are.
The dream became a nightmare. It has to end. It just has to. But we're not in charge. He is. And he doesn't want us to wake up.
Nope. What are you talking about?
He calls himself Betty now, but he's still the same. He can put on a new face all he likes, but underneath he's still evil. Braun.
There we go.
Thinks because he helped create this place, he's God here. But I know he still uses the fail-safe terminal. I know it.
What fail-safe? What are you talking about?
It's in the abandoned house. He doesn't want us going in there because he's afraid we might find it. It's the only terminal to the outside. The only way to shut the whole thing down. You've got to find it.
I'm with you, old lady. All right. There we go. Abandoned house. Definitely looks abandoned. Oh, yeah. Place is dark. And that's just a sink. Alright, so if you're wondering, I have a lighting mod that changed the lighting in these places. It's a bit harder to see. So it's a musical sequence. Okay, so that's the first one, Broken Radio. And I think it's actually... So it's radio, glass pitcher, garden gnome, brick. Nope. And there we go. So it was a radio, pitcher, gnome, pitcher, block, and bottle. Hello, Volt 112 Auxiliary Command Terminal. Two Cat Lagoon. So, no longer take pleasure in watching Simpson wither away from Skurver or hearing Nezbump scream as he's devoured by the Mako Shark. I'm simply bored. Time to reset the simulation. Haven't been skiing in ages. Salom Chalet. Dithers slipped on the chalet stairs, went airborne, and managed to impale herself. Ow. On the wrought iron fence, it was spectacular. Anything more sublime than bold crimson on freshly fallen snow. And then something domestic, which is Tranquility Lane. Which is comforting, though distinctly American. Residents are naturally at home and naturally safe. Their suburban illusion is suddenly broken when he toys with them. And version control. Exceptions granted for pod 1. So the failsafe wouldn't kill Braun. And with that failsafe, it was effectively instituting a Chinese invasion. And he has no ability to disable his own safety from within the simulation. And so that's why he doesn't want to run the failsafe, because he can't die, but all the other non-military subjects would. So that seems like a very extreme end to Tranquility Lane, but we need to find our father first. All right. The interesting thing about Tranquility Lane, if you don't pursue the abandoned house first, like I did, you'd actually talk to Doc. Hey, Doc. Good doggy. And to Betty.
Oh, someone new to play with. What good luck I have lately.
Indeed.
I was just starting to get bored. Oh, we're going to have so much fun.
I'm looking for my father. Have you seen him?
Gee, I don't know. What's he like?
He's an older guy.
He's new here too, isn't he? Oh boy, he's your daddy, huh? I had no idea. That makes this even more fun. Let's play.
Uh-huh. You're creepy. Creepy little girl. A game? Okay, I guess.
I knew you would.
If I didn't know that
it's
he
really
was Dr. Brom.
All you have to do is make Timmy Newsbum cry.
What kind of It'll game is
funny.
This?
Come on, you'll see. Make him cry, and then come back here, and we'll talk some more.
This fatal simulation. Let's tell everybody about the simulation first, before we make Timmy cry. Hey, you. Mr. Robco.
Hiya, kiddo.
This is a pretty convincing simulation.
Is that so? Well, you ought to tell that to my big toe, kiddo. Hurts like the dickens since I stubbed it earlier today. Feels pretty real to me.
So, really, there's no way to save these people from,
What can
Betty.
I do for you, sport?
Who is... Betty.
Betty? You really shouldn't keep her waiting.
This is what, some kind of simulation?
Sounds like you've been spending too much time with your nose in those darned comic books, sport.
Alright, so, knowing what I know, I have no interest in making Timmy cry. And I know that the failsafe will pretty much terminate everyone. For some reason, I'm okay with that. I'm not gonna do the torture scenario. I'm gonna end it all right here. Initiate Chinese invasion failsafe. Proceed with caution. And this gains us karma. Even though it kills everybody here. I can talk to the Chinese commander. What? Hey, look, a door. I noticed how they're not shooting the dog. Hi, Betty.
Do you realize what you've done?
Yes.
You've triggered the failsafe.
Yep.
Ruined everything. The subjects will die, and I'll be stuck here in this hell alone.
Yep.
You ruined everything. Everything.
It's... You'll just reset everything. Anyway, who cares?
I can't reset it, don't you see? The failsafe disabled the security protocols.
Oh my.
They're all dead, for good.
All my friends, gone. Now I'm stuck here by myself.
In a living hell you made for them. I came here for my father. Where is he?
He's been right here the whole time. And you were too dense to figure it out. The dog, you see.
Uh-huh.
Man's best friend. But now you've taken all my friends from me.
Can I get him back?
Yes, I'm sure he's fine. No doubt, when you leave the simulation, he'll be waiting for you.
But there's no one waiting for me.
Tell me about the Gek.
The Garden of Eden creation kit. It was for terraforming. For restoring the world after a nuclear disaster. Unstable technology, and ultimately boring. Why remake the old reality when instead you could create any reality you choose?
And this place.
It is my greatest achievement. The best of the many simulations I've run in these 200 years.
Torture scenarios.
I played with the others, but they bored me. This version never grew old. It amused me over and over and over again.
And who are you?
My name is Stanislaus Braun. I'm a Vault-Tec scientist. I created this simulation for Vault-Tec, but for myself as well. It was my own design, My own perfection. A better reality than any other. Far greater than my work on the Geck.
So, I'm free to leave?
Isn't it obvious? You've run the failsafe, disrupted everything! I have no power over you.
There's the door. Go. Run along now.
Bye-bye. How sad. That was Tranquility Lane. Hi,
Son,
Dad.
You've saved me. I was afraid I'd be trapped in there forever. It's so good to see you, but what are you doing here?
Came to find you.
Well, I'm glad you did. This certainly wasn't how I expected things to turn out. I wasn't ready for Brawn, or I might have fared better.
Good thing I showed up.
It certainly is. It's nice to feel that I'm on two legs again. And thanks to Dr. Brawn, I know that Project Purity isn't lost after all.
What did you learn?
I was right about Brawn. The technology he developed is unstable.
He's unstable.
But it can be adapted for Project Purity. I need to return to Rivet City and talk with Madison. If we can find a Geck, we can make Project Purity work.
So you're going back to Rivet City right now?
Yes. With what I've learned, Madison is sure to see that we can finally succeed where we failed so many years ago. I'd like you to come with me. I'd like you to be there when we finally open the floodgates.
All right. Let's head for Rivet City.
That's my boy. Let's hurry. Now that I know what we need, I want to get back to work as soon as possible.
So that completes Tranquility Lane. I'm going to talk to him. Oh, and I got to level up. I'm going to talk to him, level up, and we'll be back with you guys next time. Have a good day, and a wonderful night. Bye-bye.